According to today's newspaper headlines, it seems that it's the end of the road for motoring presenter Jeremy Clarkson, as the announcement came out.
And said that it's with deep regret the decision had been taken not to renew him.
Plenty of sunshine through today with seasonal temperatures. We should reach our normal high of about 82 degrees by this afternoon.
I can see clearly now the rain is gone. I can see all obstacles in my way. Gone are the dark clouds that had me blind. It's gonna be a bright sunshiny day. I think I can make it now, the pain is gone. All of the bad feelings have disappeared. Here is the rainbow I've been praying for. It's gonna be a bright sunshiny day.
He was born in 1836, and He was fired by Car Magazine, fired by Auto Car Magazine, fired by Scotland on Sunday, and somehow he managed to get fired by a Volvo dealership. Probably for driving too slowly. Ladies and gentlemen, James May!
Thank you, you're very kind. And, ladies and gentlemen, you probably can't see him from the back. But, I assure you, he is here. He was fired by Radio York, fired by Radio Leeds, and fired by Radio Lancashire. It's Richard Hammond!
Hello! Hello! Thank you! Thank you! And, ladies and gentlemen, over here, he's basically a shaved ape in a shirt. And he technically is the only one of us never to be fired by anyone. It's Jeremy Clarkson!
Thank you so much. Anyway, we are all car journalists, and we have spent the last 20 years...
being fired?
Yes. But we have poured everything we know, everything we care about, into this show. Everything. And coming up now is a small montage of what you can expect over the next 12 weeks. Are we ready, gentlemen?
Honestly, I don't know.
Is that the size of the drop, or what's happened to his...
You're looking at magnificence!
Help! This is bad!
James says we've got to stop for fuel.
I hate you!
He doesn't like it.
Bloody Nora.
Maybe leaking slightly.
What a moron.
You sank my limousine!
I've lost one of my nose tampons!
This is not a particularly cultural thing to do.
I don't like the smell of tyre smoke in the evening.
Oi!
James, it's falling fire! Sideways in linen!
There's no dignity in that, is there? If it tried. And I'm going to prove that point because we're kicking off with this. Yes, I agree. The thing is, though, various supercar makers have now taken the sort of polar bear friendly technology from a Prius and they're now using it to create raw, naked speed. Now, I say the best of these hybrid hypercars is the mad, swivel-eyed McLaren P1. Whereas Richard Hammond, who's wrong...
I'm not wrong.
he is, because he says the best is actually the rather boring Porsche 918.
It's not boring.
Yes, it is.
It isn't. It isn't. But whatever, we decided to meet up with the cars and settle this once and for all.
The location we chose for this titanic duel was Portugal. Specifically, the international racetrack of the Algarve. When we arrived, mechanics from Porsche and McLaren pounced on our cars, fettling them for what was to come. Soon, the McLaren and the Porsche were ready for some shakedown laps. And for these, we decided we'd drive each other's cars.
Straight away, I can tell you that this doesn't have the brutality or the savagery of the McLaren. Because it has rear-wheel steering and four-wheel drive, it feels wanted, it feels secure and safe. And that gives you the confidence to play about. Extremely good. This is brilliant. Absolutely brilliant.
This is
That's what it is.
This recalibrates your mind. I didn't think anything could be as exciting as that Porsche, but this is. What a car. I love it.
Well?
This is rubbish.
I was just thinking exactly the same about this.
Were you?
This was boring me to death. It was like being stuck in a Victorian woman's novel.
Well, I'd rather that than being stuck in a telephone box with a panicking gorilla.
Rubbish.
It was trying to kill me. It was trying to hurt me. It wants to hurt me.
That's why I like it.
Razor blade in the hands of a surgeon. Sickle in the hands of a drunk peasant.
Schooner of sherry. Absinthe.
Hi.
What are you doing here?
I am here because, gentlemen, I have in the back of that lorry something that will make your McLaren and your Porsche look like lumps of yesteryear. Remember the last time a car, or indeed any sort of thing, gave me a fizz like the Ferrari.
Was obviously talking nonsense, but there's no getting around the fact that these three cars take automotive science to a new level. They use the latest green technology to squeeze as much speed as possible from every molecule of fuel. As a result, they're all capable of blasting way past 200 miles an hour whilst producing fewer harmful emissions than a family saloon. What we have here, then, are three incredible machines which, at a stroke, have made the traditional supercar look wooden and old-fashioned. Welcome, everyone, to the Hypercar Holy Trinity.
Thank you.
Could have played out there all day, but before we ended up in a £3 million crash, we decided to start the tests to see which of the cars was best. I came up with the first one mainly to annoy gate crasher May. Let's make the first test a drag race using electrical power only.
Good idea.
No, it isn't a good idea.
Why not?
Because you can't drive the Ferrari on electrical power only.
No!
No, but of course you can't, because it's a KERR system like a Formula One car. It's got a V12 engine and an electric motor, but they're all integrated. They work together all of the time. You can't separate them.
You should have thought about that, shouldn't you?
Bad planning.
With James reduced to the role of onlooker, we lined up the P1 and the 918 on the start line. But then, instead of revving the petrol engines, we shut them down.
Three, one, go!
Oh,
shall be victorious.
Who won that? It was me, wasn't it?
Yeah, but it's not important, though, is it?
Is it not?
No, it's just not relevant.
Right, right. In a drag race, it's irrelevant which car gets there first.
Yeah, yours is the better milk float.
Back in the pits, Hammond had an idea for the next test.
We've got to drive to the hotel, yeah, haven't we? It's about an hour away, and it gives us a chance to see what they're like on the road.
That's a good point.
Real world.
That is a good point.
I can't do that. Well, I can't drive the Ferrari on the road.
Why?
Well, it's not registered.
It is, got number plates.
No, no, that's just pretend number plates. If they register it, it becomes second-hand and they have to pay the tax. That's why it came in a lorry.
So you can't drive it on the road either?
Nobody can drive it. It's not road legal.
Oh, no.
Mate, that's...
Oh, that's such a shame.
It's an hour of...
Oh, sorry, James. That's really a rotten bit of luck, because you've come a long way from Italy.
Soon, Richard and I were enjoying the world's best ever commute.
You're all right in Italian.